Okay, I'm here with another vendor at the Ground Up Restoration Open House this weekend. This is Mr. Hammond, and he works for Detroit Speed. So we're going to showcase some of the products that Detroit Speed has for your vehicle. So, Mr. Hammond, tell us where your company is based.
Well, with a name like Detroit Speed, one would think you would be in Detroit. And we actually started life there, but we're actually in Mooresville, North Carolina.
NASCAR country.
NASCAR country, yeah. Yep. Our owner, Kyle Tucker, started the company in Detroit when he was an engineer at General Motors. And he built a 69 Camaro that won a lot of awards, a lot of attention, and the products that we have today were on the car, control arms and such, and everybody loved them and wanted them. And he started getting phone calls from people, first all his friends, second was other people started calling and he didn't know, and then they just started making them literally out of their house there and would ship them out. And then it moved to a building in Brighton, Michigan, and then he found this building in North Carolina. At the time that he wanted to paint cars as well. We do build cars as well, and he wanted to be able to paint, and he couldn't do it there, so this building in North Carolina had a brand new paint booth, and it just kind of came to place. He decided to move the company, and we were a very small company at the time, and we've grown it over the years, so now there's over 50 employees now. So it has grown quite a bit, and we have a lot more products than just Camaro. We do a lot of other makes, and we have a lot of different offerings for Camaro customers as well as Chevelle customers as well. Mustangs, we do Mustangs as well now too. So
great.
One of the things Kyle was really we're known for is our hydroform frame. And hydroforming is just very simply, it's just a way to shape metal with cold water pressure. And basically there's two big dies and this ginormous press. We use a 120 wall, that's a 4-inch round tube of steel, and it goes into this press, and they actually inject 12,000 psi water pressure on the inside of it, and it will very quickly contour to the die. That's how our frame looks very factory looking.
Yeah, it does.
If you notice the roll edges and how it's shaped, that's how we get that. And to my knowledge, we're the only company aftermarket using it. There's not many places that do it here. Plus it's quite expensive, the dies are quite expensive obviously to do, so you have to make a fair amount of parts in order to justify it. So it gives us a very different look to it than a factory. I mean, other companies out there that make product like that, it's all kind of just square tube steel. It's a very race car looking, and this looks very factory. So it does come with a rack and pinion, you know, and there's no real good way to put a rack and pinion in a stock subframe.
Nope. Just doesn't fit.
Doesn't work very well. There are kits out there, but the drivability of the cars are not what you want, so we shy away from that. But with this new design, we were able to design it into it, and that's really one of the key features of it. The spindle that we use on that, we actually, early on, we were using C6 Corvette right from a local Chevy dealership. But there were a couple differences on that we didn't need, so we designed our own. It's actually forged up in Detroit, and then we machine it in North Carolina. And it uses it's basically a C6 Corvette. We use a C7 bearing pack on it as well. It's a very strong bearing. So any Corvette, C6 Corvette, C5, C6 Corvette brake packages will bolt right to it, whether it be factory GM, Bear, Wilwood, AP, everybody has brakes for it. So it's a very common platform to have performance brakes for it as well. And that's anywhere from a 2-piston all the way up to a 6-piston, up to like a 14-inch rotor, which would be like a Z06, Corvette would have.
14-inch rotor, and it's going to require an 18-inch wheel?
It's going to require an 18-inch wheel at that size, yeah. The spindle is tall, so a 15-inch wheel won't even go over it. So it has to be a minimum of 17. And depending on the brake package, an 18 is a little preferred. Plus, tire size is a little bit easier to find in the 18 and 17s now as well.
Yeah,
so.
Times are changing.
Yes. Yeah. So so it gives you all the features. It comes fully assembled, powder coated in a crate, literally uncrate it and bolt it right in. So it mounts no different than the factory as well.
You had mentioned that the company builds cars.
We do. Mm-hmm.
From scratch?
Yes.
Like somebody wanted a Camaro, they can get a Dynacorn body. Do you start right from step number one with one of those, or can a customer bring in their car and you'll fit everything up that they want?
Yeah, either we'll find a car for them, or they have a car and they can deliver it to us, and then we can kind of take it from there. And sometimes it's just they just want our parts put on it, and we don't do the actual body work. It just whatever the customer wants. But we mainly do turnkey, full builds. We do everything except interior. We farm that out. But all the paint, all the body work, all the fabrication work is done there as well. And they can be very custom. So it just really depends what the customer's looking for. We can help them, get where they want. You know, Kyle told me years ago that customers had these cars back in high school or before, and they want them to perform like their BMW and Mercedes now, and that's what we do. So we help them achieve that. So
people have really gotten spoiled with their daily driver. The quality of today's daily driver is leaps and bounds beyond a first generation Camaro. Even if it was restored to factory appearing original stock condition, they just don't compare to what's being produced in modern day. But you can retrofit that car with products from Detroit Speed, and you'll have your braking, your handling. You can do an LS swap, so you don't have a carburetor with a choke waiting for engine temperature to climb to be able to have good drivability. So you just have your quick turn of the key, fuel injection, you're ready to go. I had a customer that basically took the Detroit Speed catalog and clicked off everything imaginable for a 69 Camaro and just turned this car into an absolute brute. He actually considered buying a turnkey from you guys, but there was a lot of people in the business that owed him favors.
Oh.
And he decided to cash in on every single one of them and have this car built locally. I had the pleasure of inspecting it, appraising it, riding in it, and driving it, and had an LS swap. Depending on the pulley setup that he had on the blower, it could have been upwards of 1,000 crank horsepower. So this car was unbelievable to drive. And it would stop on a dime and just about give you change.
We test all our stuff before we let it go to the public. So we try to break it, basically. And if you look at any vehicle we've done, you'll see a lot of our videos and such on the racetrack, on the autocross track. And a lot of people think, well, I'm not going to race my car, I don't need that. But we do that because it really puts the extreme used to it, and we have found that that's a good way to we can improve our product by doing that sort of thing. So we do still do a lot of those events, and we're trying new parts out all the time, so you never know. But the parts are made for the street, but with our cars you can do both. You can get the good ride, you can get the superior handling, but and that's great for the racetrack, but usually race cars don't ride that well. But we can also make it ride well and stop, and that's really the kind of the key what we do. So
I can attest to the fact that your stuff doesn't break, because this Camaro that I just mentioned, its purpose was for the owner to take out his daily frustrations on the car. And the videos that he had sent me of just hammering this car, just used and abused, and it did not break. And trust me, he was not easy on the car.
Oh, yeah.
The sets of tires were stacked up in the garage just because he had spares. If it was 9 o'clock at night and he needed tires, there was an extra set, and he'd get right back out on the road and continue to abuse the car. And car never failed him. Never failed him.
That's good. So hopefully he doesn't take that too much on it.
But and it was a stick car at that.
Yeah.
So he was power shifting gears, and that without no lift shift technology or rev match or anything that they have in some of the modern cars. Again, this car took tons of abuse and never broke.
Yeah. One of the key components on our rear suspension is our swivel link. So we have a four link setup for most applications, and Kyle came up with this design years ago, and it patented, and it's still quite unique to us. So basically, you have a four link system. So there's four of these. There's usually two upper, two lower, two short, two long, and you have rubber bushings in it, and then you also have where this swivels. So it allows the rear end to articulate, and so it can move around. If you hit a pothole or hit a bump, one side goes up, one side goes down, your rear end's on this number. But allows it to move without upsetting the car. So it keeps the rear tire in contact with the ground, but it also, with the rubber bushings, absorbs a lot of shock and vibration, so you don't get all that transferred to the car, so the ride quality goes up. And that's a key reason our rear suspension in particular works so well. Is this here. A lot of the Chevelles, we have a little cutaway here. This is a Chevelle, an A-body, if you will. They come with, these just bolt right in. There's no modifications to the car at all on those. And it gives the same effect for it. This one is shown with a coilover, which we do that as well. And we make it for the stock 10-bolt, 12-bolt, or you can do an aftermarket as well, a rear end, such as a Moser or something like that. We have different bracketry for that. We also do a sway bar. It's not pictured here, but all that is just bolt-in parts for that. And that really transforms the ride of a car, particularly with an A-body, is a full-frame car. So it, you know, it can really benefit a lot. The factory doesn't, you know, when they do, all the movements in the bushing. And the bushing gets a lot of abuse, and it can wear, it can get play in it. So your rear end can actually move around on you, and the ride quality will go down when that happens. This doesn't have any of that forces are applied to it because it allows it to turn, allows it to twist. So
you had mentioned that this is a Chevelle, a GMA body. Your sway bar has an adjustable link that mounts to the upper cross member. It's
yes.
No longer on the lower control arm.
Correct, which is not where you have the factory. We redid it. The factory at the time, I guess they, I don't know why they did it that way, but that's not, you want to take the body roll out of the car and on the lower control arm is not the most best way, so we actually improved that. And it just has a U-bolt link that connects to the 3-inch on the 12-bolt or 10-bolt, and then it actually goes up to the front of the car. We actually do put two holes in the mounting holes of it, so you can add if you want a little stiffer, you can actually move it over and it will increase the rate quite a bit. So very simple to do. You can do it on the car. It's very easy to do. So we give you some flexibility of adjusting it as well. So.
Are those sway bars hollow or solid?
They're hollow.
They're hollow. Mm-hmm. Lightweight.
Yeah. So we actually make them in house in North Carolina. We powder coat them, and all it comes with all the hardware, everything you need to bolt it right in. So.
Yeah. I have a friend with a 71 Chevelle that has a one of your bars. He considered another manufacturer whose design is basically just the same, again to the rear cross member, but he was going to be drag racing the car. Mm-hmm. So he had a concern for weight of the overall vehicle, and because that solid bar was incredibly heavy.
Yeah.
So he decided to go with your product. So he literally drives the car to the drag strip. It's an LS swap car.
Mm-hmm.
Runs well into the 10 second category, turns around and drives the car home. The car hooks and books, and a lot of it is, he has adjustable upper control arms, such as these, and that sway bar made all the difference in the world in the way that the car would 60 foot and you know, just run straight and true up the other end. So you know, he's running 1070s again off on his street legal tires, drives it an hour and a half, 2 hours to the track, doesn't swap wheels, tires or anything, puts on his helmet, makes his pass, runs 1070s for the day and turns around and goes home. And a great majority of, you know, obviously he's making some horsepower, but the car 60 foots incredibly well, and that's a testament to the products that they have at Detroit Speed.
A lot of our customers used to be, you know, you build a car and they go take it to show and whatnot and sit in your lawn chair and you show your car with the hood up. And that still, a lot of customers still do that. But there are customers that like to go do some events, whether it be a drag race, whether it be an autocross, or even getting out there with the SCCA guys and running some local road courses and whatnot. And our products are really meant to do both. We can give you a comfortable ride, we can give you a stable, much stabler car, but we can also make it handle a lot better as well, a lot more fun to drive. So that's really what we're all about.
Great. I see on your list here, on your pop-up display.
Yes.
You know, we've talked about some front suspension and rear suspension things.
Yeah.
For body stuff, is that talking about building a complete car for someone?
It can be. We do some body components like our tubs, our mini tub kits, which are pretty famous out there.
Which were in that Camaro I mentioned a few minutes ago. It was a mini tub car.
Right. So basically, they're stamped in Detroit. They look just like the factory. They're the inner portion of the wheel tub, and it mates up to the factory outer, but it allows you to put a wider wheel and tire package in a car. And that's, so we basically give you more real estate back there to work with. Those are some of the body items we do. Steering, we do. We have steering racks that we do. We consume them in our frames, whether it be a Mustang, whether it be a Chevy 2 or a Camaro. We have a lot of different versions. And we also do a lot of power steering as well. We have a 600 gearbox. Chevelle was another one we couldn't do a rack for, so we have a 600 box for that. It gives you a rack feel, but it's still a steering box, so it's easy, it bolts in, it's easy to do. But it does require a power steering pump, which we do as well. So we do have a lot of steering components. Electrical, we do the RS headlight kits. We also have Corvette C2, C3 with the pop-up headlights.
Electric motors, get rid of the vacuum operating.
Get rid of the vacuum, which are troublesome to say the least.
Yeah, and, say the least. Just looked at one of those cars the other day.
Right.
Full-blown, complete inspection on the car. So, of course, one of the things you have to do is check the headlight operation.
Right.
Here comes the driver's door right on time, and I stood there and waited and waited and waited, and finally the passenger headlight door opened. But when the headlight shut off, the left one articulated close, and the right one just stayed open.
Yeah.
So all that is solved with one of your electric motor kits.
Right. So we offer a 68 and 69. Each year of the first-gen Camaros were different. The 67s were electric to start with. They're very troublesome as well. The 68 went to vacuum, and then they changed it again in 69 because they were trying to improve it. But they are problematic, and a lot of times, especially if you put a bigger engine, bigger cam in it, then it rely on engine vacuum. So I've seen a lot of them where they start to close if you get on it. When your engine vacuum drops, the headlights will start to close because they don't have the vacuum to keep them open.
And that is actually opening up the door when in fact it's just the opposite. It's the vacuum that is holding them closed. So as he mentioned, when you go wide open throttle, your vacuum drops to zero and you'll watch your headlight doors open. Or if you're in a Corvette, sometimes they'll pop up.
Yeah. So we offer kits for that they look factory. They tied to the factory headlight switch, so there's nothing on the dash that would change the look of it.
There a relay in the system?
There is a there's no relay. There is a module for those that will tell the motors what to do and when to do it.
Yeah.
So it's kind of the brain of the system, if you will. That mounts up under the dash on all the applications. And then you just have wiring that runs up to the motors. The motors will bolt right in to the car, depending on the application for it. Like I said, the Corvettes do pop up, and down, and those we sell a ton of those, because there's a lot of those cars out there as well.
Mm-hmm.
We also do wiper kits.
I was going to say, you have a 3-speed wiper motor.
We actually have a 5-speed. We have five intermittent speeds, a low speed and a high speed. So you can add a modern wiper kit to an older car. The newer kits now have a washer facility in them. You just press it and there's an optional, not everybody needs a washer or wants a washer, but it is optional. And now they can, it will go, if you press it just like you would a car, it will go into a 3 low speed wipe. and then go back to whatever it was doing. So very, very easy thing to do. The motor is a lot smaller. First gen customers with big blocks understand that. There's no room right there, so our motor is much narrower, so it will clear the valve covers where some of those won't, depending on the engine. So particularly guys with tall valve covers on big blocks, that real estate is, factory motors are so large.
Yeah. Or somebody with a tall deck 572.
Exactly.
They're
going to run into a problem with that, yeah. So a lot of those cars, they'll take it off and not have wipers on it. So here's a good way to have a modern kit that uses, and it will come with the correct knob for the each application. And we have all sorts of applications. We just released some B-body, some Impala, full-size body cars of the 60s. We have C10 trucks for them as well. We have a lot of applications for that, not only for the A-body and then, of course, the Camaros, but for others as well. Chevy 2s we do, as well as some of the early Chevelles as well.
Speaking of Chevy 2s, do you have a complete bolt-on front end kit?
We do. It's not a hydroform. It's the Chevy 2s are a bolt in, but they're so short. It wasn't really worth the energy and time and the money to invest in the hydroforming. So we actually do have a bolt in with the down tubes on it. They come with it. We also have inner fenders that are stamped out as well. So very clean look to the car.
Yeah.
All bolt in parts. Same spindle, same steering rack as the Camaros have. So the same brake packages, all that is the same. So, and then that's true with the Mustangs as well. Mustang's a little different with a Luma frame. It's a sandwich idea. That's not a subframe car. It's a full, it's a unibody car.
Right.
So they have the frame rails with it, and the aluminum frame actually will get sandwiched on top and bottom of the stock rail, but it uses the same spindle. And for the Ford customer, we do offer it with a Ford bolt pattern, which is a little different than the GM. So we offer it either way. If they want to use GM wheels, they can. We just, they can order the right part number to have the right bearing package in.
Okay. So when we get into fuel system and driveline.
Fuel system, we do a lot of tanks. Our tanks are made by a company called Rock Valley out of Illinois. They've been making them for a long, long time. We have a lot of different variations. When you put a modern injected engine into a older car, fuel pumps are an issue. If you put like an LS engine into it, you have to have the correct pump. And if it's a supercharged engine, if it's making a lot of power, there are some different pump options to have it. So our latest is a 600 horsepower and a 1,000 horsepower. Tanks are identical. The difference is the pump. One has just a single pump in it, one has two pumps in it.
Okay.
And there's a controller that will tell the pumps what the engine will tell the pumps, hey, I need more fuel. It will tell it to start up and run, so it's fully automatic.
As people are getting into either very large single turbo or twin turbo applications, fuel demand is a major concern.
The LTs, the new LT crate motors, they're actually direct injection, and they're about 2,000 PSI. They have a mechanical pump, but you do need a different pump to feed it, electric pump, and we do have those available as well.
Great.
So in keeping up with the times, those are the new crate motors from GM on that.
And that's the new rage.
Yeah, it is.
The new LT4.
Exactly. So they're all stainless steel. Those all have dual pickups in the corners. Gone are the days when you got down to a quarter of a tank, you had to stop for fuel. If you hit a corner, it would start. Those are all done. They're baffled per application in there. We narrow them as well. Some of our leaf spring suspensions require a narrowed fuel tank. We also cut the corners, the front facing corners on it to help run exhaust in the back. It gets kind of tight back there. So little things like that we do to really make it easier to install in the car.
All real world application stuff.
Yeah. So in drivetrain, we've always, our quadrilink systems do require bracketry to be welded on the rear end. So we do provide housings and axles. And Kyle recently bought CNR South and in Mooresville and renamed it Gear FX. So they make our 9 inches, our 12 volts, everything now. They're actually made there, right, they're only 2 miles from us in Mooresville. We have a dyno for a Ford 9-inch that we can actually dyno the engines, or rather the rear ends, and then we can send it complete. So gone are the days where you have to break a 9-inch in anymore. We can do that for you now.
I have one of those in the garage. I can send it to you.
Yeah, absolutely. As long as it's a 31 spline, we can bolt it right up.
As a matter of fact, it is. Yeah. It'd be a lot easier to have it done that way, rather, because I have... there's a new engine in the car, new ceramic coated headers that need to be broken in, and trying to run the engine certain temperature, certain time, and then be concerned about breaking in the rear as well. That's a neat feature.
It is. It really is.
And you're able to ship it with fluid in it?
We don't ship it with fluid in it, but it's ready when you get it. It's ready to
add your fuel and away you go.
Exactly. And we do complete, or we do it, and we can do just the housing. A lot of customers don't have capabilities of welding the brackets on. There is a correct angle they have to be, and we can provide that for them. So we can do just the housing. We can sell them all the parts. They can sell it themselves, or we can send it fully assembled, ready to go.
So a customer can make it one-stop shopping, basically, saying, here's what I want. It needs to be all bolt in. You guys do all the geometry, all the welding, and what they get, just bolt it right in the car, and away they go.
It makes it a lot easier. You can do it at your house, at your garage. Not everybody's a professional builder. We get that. So
there's still a lot of guys working in their garage.
Absolutely. Yep.
It's been an absolute pleasure, sir.
Absolutely, Jim. Thank you.
All right. So there you have it, folks. Detroit Speed. Tremendous website. Visit them. See what they have. Start clicking off the boxes. Next thing you know, it's going to be like Christmas time at your house with all this new stuff arriving. It's springtime. Time to upgrade your car, get it on the road, and enjoy it. Thanks for watching.
Muscle Car Appraisal thanks you for watching our video. Please subscribe to our channel. Please like our video and hit the bell notification. And once again, we thank you for looking at our video. Have a great day.